Okay guys, today we're talking terpenes. Most notably, these four, how they impact your body and the cannabis experience. My day-to-day job is with GreenLink International. We own the brands, recipes, intellectual property, trademarks, real estate. We also consult and provide management contracts to cannabis operations throughout the US and Canada. Our primary objective as a publicly traded company is to bring our products, brands, and services to as many people as possible throughout the market. Last week, I had the opportunity to travel the Pacific Northwest with our partner, Northwest Bakery Services, which handles all the production and distribution to the Washington market. And I was surprised to find out how many of the accounts we visited didn't understand what, how, or why we made our products the way we do. Also surprised to find out the disparity between shops that really cared about what was going into the products, how they affect the body, and the companies that simply cared about getting a 10 milligram dose for as cheap as humanly possible. And I was really surprised to find out how many of the retailers we went to basically said, lower the price by X and I will buy $5,000 a week and get rid of this guy. I don't care whether it's RSO, I don't care whether it's distillate, I don't care. Whatever it is, as long as it's got 10 milligrams of THC and I can sell it for fill in the blank. That story was told at about a third of the retailers we went and visited, and it was extremely disheartening because for us, we know those products are not the same and they don't offer the same effectiveness. And in fact, you're actually paying more for it. If you've got to take twice as much, you're effectively paying twice as much. So I found it really frustrating when people would do that. I was also surprised how many shops had really, really knowledgeable staff that understood the importance of RSO also. And really, RSO isn't what makes it so important. It's RSO is just full spectrum, meaning that all those other terpenes are already in the extract that we start with, giving us an advantage, but then taking it a step further by adding more of those. So we've got myrcene that helps break the blood-brain barrier, carophyllene, alpha-pinene, and limonene. The last few years have changed the game when it comes to terpenes and essential oils found in cannabis. Now that we're starting to understand the effects of the other terpenes found in cannabis and what they do to the body, we are able to isolate those in other products and find bioidentical versions of them and reintroduce them into cannabis products. So when you guys are out shopping for products, make sure you're asking the people that are selling you these things whether or not it's made with RSO, is it full spectrum, is it broad spectrum? These are all questions that if they can't answer, I suggest you find yourself something with a Sweet Nirvana logo on it. Anything that carries this little medallion logo on it from our company, you will know that these products are not only full spectrum RSO, but they've also had additional terpenes added to them to increase the effective dose in every single product. If 10 milligrams is not a strong enough dose in an edible for you because you are a regular consumer or your body just doesn't react to 10 milligrams, I would recommend trying one of these products because on top of the effects you get from the increased terpene profile, that carries over into smokable and vapable products as well. So if you consume one of these edibles and you're having a mild experience, please use caution because it will also increase the effectiveness of the cannabis that you either smoked or vaped. So use caution, enjoy the products, find things that are made with RSO or at least terpene enhanced full spectrum would be ideal. But if you can't get it, find yourself a product that has had terpenes reintroduced to the distillate or the isolate so that you can get a maximum dose.